All hail the beard, it's your boy Big Beard B, and we back for another edition of Big Beard Business. Yes, man, you already know what time it is. Spring has officially sprung. I already dropped my designer spring fragrance list, and today I am back with my niche fragrance list. Now, before I hop into this list, man, here's a few things to understand. These are fragrances that I enjoy, fragrances that I will be wearing this spring of 2020, and hopefully you enjoy them as well or think about trying them out. If not, I get it. Now, listen, man, I like what I like when it comes down to fragrances, and I like fragrances that garner me compliments. So, some of you may feel like this list may be juvenile or maybe entry, but I like what I like. The fragrance in the number 10 spot is a bit different. It has this bitter rhubarb note in here. It has aldehydes. It also has some bergamot and some notes that you would like, but this one is a little different. This one comes from Kilian, and it's none other than Kilian's Vodka on the Rocks. Now, Vodka on the Rocks is this fresh citrus-based fragrance. You have a lot of florals in this one as well. You have some notes of rose in here. You also have some lily. And this one is a bit different, as I've stated. When I think of the Kilian line in itself, there are a lot of dark fragrances there. But this is one of the freshies that stand out. Now, this one does get some, I guess, some criticism for not having the longest projection and performance out there, but these fragrances are easy to reapply, and personally, I don't have any issues with it when I wear it. So, at number 10 spot, we have Kilian's Vodka on the Rocks. Now, this next fragrance on the list is one that was introduced to me a few years ago, but I've really grown to enjoy this fragrance. Actually, when I first smelled it, I really, really enjoyed it. I have since added it to my collection. This one comes from Imaginary Authors, and this one is Saint Julep. Now, this one is sweet. It's mint. It has some imaginary notes in here as well as the Imaginary Author fragrances do, but I really like this one. This one is sweet, it's fresh, it's airy, it's inviting, and this one will definitely help you stand out. The compliment factor is great on this one. It doesn't project a ton off the skin, but this one does give you like a moderate projection. Those who are around your immediate scent bubble will be able to smell this one. And with it being a fresh fragrance, this one still draws you in with that sweet, I think it's like this bourbon sugar or sugar cane, sugar cube, whatever. I really enjoy this fragrance. I think you will like it as well. And it kind of reminds me of a julep. So there you go. Now, the next fragrance on this list made my overall spring list for 2019, and I decided to split it up this year. So, to me, this one is not for everyone, but I think that most people do enjoy it. This one isn't for everyone because it has heavy musk in it, in my personal opinion. This one comes from Creed, and it's none other than Creed's Himalaya. Now, this one is airy, it's fresh, it just draws you in my personal opinion. This one is a manly scent. Now, a lot of Creed fragrances are marketed as unisex, but to me, this one is manly. You have heavy musk, you have some wood notes in here as well, and it's also bright, fresh, and inviting. I think this one is strong. It has moderate performance, the CR, the projection, and all those things there, but the compliment factor for me has been great. I enjoy this fragrance, one that I love to have in my collection. I could probably make this spring list and summer list all on Creed fragrances, but this is definitely one that stands out to me, Creed's Himalaya. And speaking of fragrances that stand out to me, this one definitely stands out to me. And to me, this one was love at first sniff. This one comes from Bond, and it's none other than Bond No. 9's Shelter Island. Now, like Himalaya, this one also made my all-in list for spring for 2019, and it's for good reason that it makes this list. I feel like Shelter Island is different, as it's this marine fragrance with oud in it, and I feel like that's a different play, a different take on oud all in all. Now, I personally don't know a ton of fragrances that do this oud note well for spring and summer fragrances, but Bond has got it right with this one. This one's myrrh, it's musk, it's oud, it's amber, it's lily, it's citrusy, it's zesty, and a fragrance that I really enjoy. This will probably make a ton of my list over and over and over again. One of my favorites from the house of Bond. Again, this one is Bond No. 9's Shelter Island. So my fragrance in the number six spot was released in 2018. I believe I put this one in my collection in late 2018 or sometime in 2019. This one is light florals, it's light fruits, it's geranium. This one has lavender, and this one is from Parfum de Marly, and this one is Percival. Now, Percival definitely gets you compliments and one of the lighter offerings from the house of Parfum de Marly. All right, so when I think of their fragrances, a lot of heavy fragrances come to mind. You have Aujon, you have Leighton, you have Leighton Exclusif, you have Delina on the ladies' side, but this one here really stands out to me. This is definitely one of their better offerings for spring and summer. Now, I definitely like Sedley, but I don't have Sedley in my collection, which is why, sadly, it can't make today's list. But this is definitely one that you should try if you have this one in your collection. This is a great one for spring and summer. Percival from the house of Parfum de Marly. Now, we are halfway through the list, and this next fragrance we're discussing was one that was actually recommended to me by a subscriber. He sent me a sample of it. I fell in love with it. I purchased it, and every fragrance that I've purchased from his house since then has been a blind buy. This fragrance is Mojave Ghost from Byredo. Listen, Mojave Ghost is a super nice fragrance. I put this one on fresh out of the shower. A lot of the times I will put this on my underclothes just because I want to have that nice, fresh, clean, inviting feel overall. And I think that this one definitely does it. Mojave Ghost is amber ambrette. This one is musk. It's light, it's airy, it's inviting. I haven't really come across anyone who doesn't enjoy this fragrance. Mojave Ghost to me is a unisex scent, and I'm sure this one is marketed as a unisex scent. I enjoy it, my wife enjoys it. I think the only criticism that I would have of this fragrance is at times, especially on that initial spray, it comes off smelling a bit like women's hairspray. But outside of that, as it begins to dry down, this one is really nice and definitely one that stands out to me in the spring and summer. Mojave Ghost from Byredo. This next fragrance has been in my collection for a number of years, and I will continue to buy this fragrance. If I did like an update, I think this was definitely on my 10 for life on the niche edition that I did with Saks Fifth Avenue. I really enjoy this fragrance, and a lot of people out there enjoy this fragrance as well. This one comes from Creed, and this one is Creed's Green Irish Tweed. I think this one was like on the first list video I ever did for fragrances, which was my top three most complimented Creed fragrances, which was made up of Aventus, Green Irish Tweed, and also Silver Mountain Water. This one really, really stands out. I enjoy this fragrance. This one is springtime in a bottle. I know it's cliche to say, and a number of people have said it, but it's for good reason. I don't care what formulation of Green Irish Tweed you get, this one is definitely spring. To me, this one is a green, manly scent. It's fresh, it's inviting, and this one is indicative of what a spring fragrance should be, in my personal opinion. There was like this Miami edition of Green Irish Tweed, and it came in these two different bottles, which spiked the price way up, but they were more like art pieces than just Creed fragrances in themselves. I enjoy this fragrance, and I know a number of people out there enjoy it as well, and you probably expected this one to be on the list, Creed's Green Irish Tweed. Now, we are down to the final three fragrances on today's list, and the fragrance in the number three spot was introduced into my collection back in 2018. I wore this one down in Miami. I got a ton of compliments with it. I received this one from Inicio, and this one is Inicio's Rehab. All right, now Rehab to me is a super nice scent. All right, I get a lot of compliments with this fragrance when I wear it. To me, this one is seductive. It's a bit more warm and a bit different than what you would come to expect in a spring fragrance. Most people will probably wear this one in the fall, possibly heading into that winter time frame, but I really, really like this fragrance. I lived in Florida for a number of years, so for the most part, it was always spring and summer to me, so I had to wear it in those type of occasions. And I'm telling you that this thing here works. It's great compliment factor, it's spicy, it's alluring, it's seductive, and everything that I want in a fragrance, and it gives me that different oomph and that different feel in the springtime. So there you have it, man. Rehab from Inicio, solid fragrance to have in the collection, and I think you should try it if you don't already have it. Now, this next fragrance on the list comes from Bond, and I've talked about this fragrance a number of times. I really, really like it. I was actually doing a Killian event, and I came across this fragrance. I was in Saks, and we were doing an event, and this one, like, it just launched. And the fragrance I'm talking about is Lafayette Street from Bond No. 9. And I was there for Killian, but I'm like, damn. This is super, super nice. People who were there, I was talking to them. Obviously, we explored the Bond line as well. And a lot of people that I was with ended up picking up this fragrance. And I think they picked it up because it was just amazing. But yeah, that's why they picked it up. This is just an amazing scent. I've talked about this one a number of times. I have it in my collection. I've beat this bottle up, as you can see. Like in the back of it, it's beat up. Here, it's beat up. Nonetheless, I enjoy this fragrance. This one is clean, clean, clean. Spring and summer fragrance all day. You can wear this fragrance, has good staying power. And some of these notes in here are probably in a lot of your favorite fragrances. This one has tonka bean, you have vanilla, ambroxan, you have some fresh floral notes, you have some woody notes, and you also have bergamot in this fragrance as well. I enjoy it, and I think a lot of you out there enjoy it as well. This is probably one that you need to try. All right, so if you were going to a Bond testing bar or smelling station, this is one that I'm going to tell you to reach for. Grab this one all day, all night. Pick this thing up. I think you'll enjoy it as much as I have. And the compliment factor is there for this fragrance here. I enjoy it. I think you will as well. I know I said that a number of times, but definitely one that you can wear in the spring and summer. Bond No. 9's Lafayette Street. And the fragrance in the number one spot is sensual, it's woody, it's fresh. This one is a modern classic fragrance and one that gets me a lot of compliments. This one is from Mancetta, and this one is Mancetta's Cedre Bois. Woo! This thing is flame emojis all day, man. Listen, I really, really like this fragrance. I wear it a lot in like office settings, and this is like manly, masculine, woody, sensual, all in one. This embodies a lot of those feelings that you want in a fragrance. You have leather, you have oak marsh, you have vanilla, you have bergamot in this thing, you have some spices. This is just a manly man scent that smells well. Women enjoy this fragrance on you. You are going to enjoy it, and this one is really not going to offend anyone. I can do varying sprays on this one, so if I go light, I can go 3, I can go 5, and this one has great staying power as well. One of my favorites from the House of Mancetta, from the fragrances that I've smelled, this one deserves the number one spot. This one is Cedre Bois from Mancetta. All right, so those are 10 that I am rocking this spring. Comment down below and let me know what fragrances you are going to wear this spring. I know there are a number of fragrances out there that a lot of people enjoy, that I enjoy as well. Obviously, you have Aventus, you have Aventus cologne that are out there, right? You have, you know, Stevens fragrance, Intimus. I was actually really about to put that one on here, but I have to come to learn that one a bit more before I take it and put it in this spot. But it was on the list, man. It was on the list. So there are a lot of fragrances out there that are good for spring and summer. Definitely the spring here is what we're talking about more specifically. I enjoy these fragrances on this list. I would love to hear what you are rocking this spring. Any fragrances that I need to pick up, hit me up. I would love to know. As always, I'm your boy, Big B. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Tell a friend to tell a friend. We are back again. And you already know what to do. Just hit the goddamn bell.